Hello, my name is Mary Kleiber. I was the primary caregiver for my daughter, Kelly Regan, when she had her double lung transplant in November of 2018. At the time of Kelly's transplant, I already felt like a confident caregiver. You feel the same. You may have been taking care of a loved one for quite some time. You may have the experience that you need without even realizing it. One important thing that I did learn was you need to have co-caregivers to help you. I was very fortunate to have a few of them. You need to take a break for yourself. Get some rest, go do something, relax, give yourself a break. It's very important, even if it was just for a few hours. And don't be afraid to ask people for help. Family, friends, they want to help. They want to be a part of this miraculous journey. Don't be afraid to ask them. Also, feel free to reach out to the medical team. They can offer guidance as well. You will need to get a few things in order. I always kept a packed suitcase in my car. For quite some time, it was almost a year, so I had to change my clothes out depending on the season. But be prepared. Have an extra phone charger. I had a list of family and friends to keep in contact with. I had their email addresses. I had their cell phone numbers. I had Kelly's employer information. I kept them updated. Everybody wants to know what's going on. If you're currently working, it would be a good idea to investigate family leave. Have that in place, have it taken care of so that you don't have to worry about it when you're at the hospital, taking care of your loved one. There is a website that might also give you information, and that would be transplantliving.org for some guidance and support. I met several people in the hospital during Kelly's stay that were going through similar circumstances. They provided me with an enormous amount of support, and it was great. Everyone was just wonderful. And I wish wholeheartedly the best of luck to you, and God bless.